ุณผู้ชมคะเรามาต่อในเรื่องของภาพการลงทุนและการทำธุรกิจระหว่างประเทศอังกฤษและประเทศไทยกันบ้างนะคะซึ่งล่าสุดค่ะทางสถานเอกอัครราชทูตอังกฤษประจำประเทศไทยได้มีการจัดงานที่มีชื่อว่า UK Thailand Financial Conference ขึ้นนะคะซึ่งเป็นการฉายภาพค่ะคุณผู้ชมในมิติในเรื่องของการทำธุรกิจและการลงทุนระหว่างประเทศอังกฤษและประเทศไทยนะคะซึ่งในโอกาสครั้งนี้ค่ะโอปอได้ไปพูดคุยและไปสัมภาษณ์กับท่านลอร์ดโดเมนิกจอห์นสันออฟเลนสตันนะคะท่านเป็นรัฐมนตรีช่วยว่าการกระทรวงธุรกิจและการลงทุนประจำประเทศอังกฤษค่ะท่านได้มาฉายภาพค่ะคุณไอซ์ในเรื่องของการลงทุนระหว่างประเทศไทยและประเทศอังกฤษบทสัมภาษณ์จะเป็นอย่างไรเราไปติดตามกันได้เลยค่ะ
First of all, I would like to greeting in Thailand and welcome to Thailand
Thank
and welcome
you
to Krung Thep Thurakit Biz Insight Program.
Thank
First
you.
of all, Minister, Thailand and United States are upgrade for the strategy partnership together in terms of the trade and investment. So what we will can see in the big picture in the future?
Well, thank you. Firstly, thank you for having me on your show. It's
yes.
a great privilege. I love talking about the relationship between the UK and Thailand. And we're here to celebrate the opportunities in investment and financial services. So the UK financial services industry is basically the biggest in the world in terms of international finance. And London, or the city, as we call it, is an enormously important conduit for investment into Thailand. It's probably the key driver of liquidity for global investment into this nation. So we're here to work out ways in which we can enhance that. How can we do more? How can we get more UK companies investing on the ground in Thailand? And very importantly, from my point of view, I'm the investment minister, so I want more Thai companies to be investing in the UK.
Great.
And there are many of them, and I'm keen to talk about them.
Yes, and I would like to know how is the possibility that we can increase cooperation together in trade and investment, especially in FTA agreement in the
yes.
future?
Yes, well, it's a great idea. I mean, I think the more relationship, the stronger relationship we can have between the UK and Thailand, the better.
Yes.
So we started this with our enhanced trade partnership dialogue, which is a really important way to look at some of the specific issues. So it could be tariffs on spirits, our wonderful Scotch whiskey, actually some of it made by Thai companies.
Yes.
It could be ways to look at lowering barriers to investment when there are specific sort of common ownership local ownership laws and so on in terms of how we can get more UK money into Thailand, how we can make that easier. It could be in areas such as healthcare, life sciences and pharmaceuticals, these life-saving drugs that are being developed by companies like GSK on the ground in Thailand. How can we help speed up approval processes for these new types of sort of gene therapies and so on that are so important? So, you know, dialogue, discussion between regulators and governments is really important. And that allows us then to have a foundation stone that will allow us to have, you know, a full agreement in the future. So it's something that, you know, we all look forward to, but it's important to get the building blocks right along the road so that then we can develop closer economic ties and then move forward to the next stage.
And what are the sector for the investment that UK investor interest to invest in Thailand?
Yeah, well, it's amazing. I mean, so my own personal background before I went into politics was an investor in Thailand. I had an emerging markets fund management business run out of the UK, taking capital from all over the world and investing it in countries like Thailand. And there are a number of really extraordinarily powerful and long long investing organisations like HSBC, Standard Chartered, Aberdeen, operating on the ground in Thailand. The life sciences sector like GSK, AstraZeneca and so on, again, invested here, not just in terms of manufacturing, but also R&D. So you know, these drugs are being developed in this country that we can then use back in the UK. And then manufacturing. Thailand has led the way in terms of advanced manufacturing, particularly in the auto industry. So how can we invest more in those sorts of concepts? And then in return, what can you get out of the UK? Some of our top football teams are owned by Thai investors. Formula One, there's huge educational links, food and beverages and hotels and hospitality. So there are so many complementary links between our two economies.
And how the big project, because Thailand have the high potentials
yes.
for the industry area like EEC regions. And how about the UK investor for the big project, big industry?
Yeah, very important. So infrastructure is the future. I mean, all our economies need to invest in critical infrastructure. This is power, this is communications, this is AI, data centers.
Right.
Thailand's pioneering all this stuff, so it's amazing. So it's for the UK to partnership with this country. I think two areas really interest me, one of which is sustainable energy. And in the UK, which is a little known fact, but the biggest wind farms in the world, they're off the shores of the UK in our stormy seas. We have plenty of wind and rain, which is phenomenal when it comes to driving sustainable energy opportunities. how can we take our know-how mm-hmm. in developing these very complex technologies and move them to Thailand, where we need to also see a sustainable energy revolution. Mm-hmm. So that's a very exciting opportunity right. in terms of investment. And a number of Thai companies, mm-hmm. Like Gulf Energy or PTT, are investing in the UK, not just to get great returns, yeah. but to do a knowledge transfer, wow. to learn and bring back to Thailand. And the second sector is technology, AI.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be replaced quite yet by AI, maybe at some point in the future, but how do we learn from each other? How do we build these data centers? How do we have the expertise to develop the IP, so right. the intellectual property, mm-hmm. which if we don't develop in our own home nations, will be developed for us by other nations. Mm-hmm. So it's actually a critically important economic race.
And how about the green economy for the UK investor interested for this section?
Well, very important, absolutely very right. important. So as I say, so the sort of manufacturing know-how mm-hmm. in terms of how you build these incredible offshore wind platforms and floating offshore wind, which right. could be huge in terms of transferring technology from the UK. But we can learn a lot from you in terms of floating offshore solar, mm-hmm. which is something that Thailand's been developing yeah. very successfully.
We so have it, plenty
it's,
solar.
It's a wind, you've got plenty of sun, we've got plenty of wind, and we combine the two, and we've got sustainable and affordable energy. Mm-hmm. And if you think, what I find so fascinating is the AI revolution. People sort of talk about computers, but the reality is the power, mm-hmm. the electricity needed to power these big data centers is sometimes the size of an entire city. The requirement mm-hmm. is the same for a single data center. So we have to have affordable and sustainable energy mm-hmm. In order to power the next generation, sort of iteration of technologies. Mm-hmm. So the cooperation between Thailand and the UK on that is essential for both our economies.
Mm-hmm. And one thing that's very important is the financial support from the UK government for the investor. What is strategy for your government to support for the investor?
Absolutely right. Well, thank you for raising that. I mean, one of the things I'm going to celebrate today at this wonderful Thai UK Financial Service yes. Conference is an MOU mm-hmm. between our export finance arm, UKEF, and your Thai export finance arm, and a collaboration in yes. terms of our government investment mm-hmm. in securing sort of loan guarantees mm-hmm. for a company based here, involved in the space sector, using UK components and mm-hmm. technology. That's a fabulous marriage mm-hmm. of UK government support financially, UK know-how and IP, Thailand manufacturing capabilities and entrepreneurship. So that's a great example mm-hmm. of where the government has stepped in to support that. We invest in the UK, I mean, tens of billions in yes. terms of R&D. So mm-hmm. we're very aware of the need
yes.
to put money into university spin-outs, mm-hmm. to invest in companies. So the UK government is the biggest venture capital
yes.
company in the UK, amazingly, in terms mm-hmm. of investing billions of pounds in, mm-hmm. in new businesses, both in terms of equity and in helping underwrite loans and to support those industries. And then skills and training. At the end of the day, it's about the bright people. Our
yes.
brains are our best defense.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And clearly, there's the education budget. Mm-hmm. But actually, we've been investing a huge amount in upskilling in terms mm-hmm. of technology, particularly in
Very
terms
important.
Of AI, new technologies such as fusion, these amazing possibilities of bottling the power of the sun in a bottle. It's completely incredible. And all the new sort of deep tech sectors we're pouring money in to make sure that we can attract the best talent internationally. Mm-hmm. And then we can give these individuals the support both to learn these skills mm-hmm. and develop on our technologies, but also to take them and commercialize them and build them into really powerful businesses.
Developing is very important.
It's very important.
Well, so for Thai investor who interested to invest in United Kingdom, what is the United Kingdom government support for the Thai investor?
Yeah, that's a great point, actually. I mean, we sit alongside on the clean energy side. We basically support offshore wind, other concepts such as hydrogen creation, and other forms of sustainable energy. We support that through giving sort of guaranteed offtake prices. So a number of your companies, as I say, like Gulf and PTT, are going to be taking advantage of government support and encouragement to come to the UK.
Mm-hmm.
But also, if I think of the other industries, so you've got CP Foods, you've got Fraser Suites, Thai Bev, some of your big cement businesses and so on, they're investing in the UK and they're investing in a growing and exciting economy. So it's not just about government support, which mm-hmm. is very well targeted, and it's enabled us to completely rejuvenate our advanced manufacturing base, for example, in autos, where we can do a great deal of work mm-hmm. with the Thai auto industry and learn from you here. But it's also about putting money into an economy
yes.
that's going to give you great returns.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got a thriving and vibrant economy. Really important, and this is one key message that mm-hmm. is part of my agenda when coming to Thailand, is to promote the whole of the UK.
Yes.
And as I've spent the last 50 years living in Britain, I've seen the development of the economy from one that was very focused around London and the South East,
yes.
where many of your colleagues and friends will have made property investments or been to school or whatever,
mm-hmm, right.
And those links are not to be underrated. But now we're seeing the resurgimento of the British regional capitals. So you've got Manchester, Birmingham, Newcastle, Belfast, all these amazing cities, Edinburgh, that are really showing phenomenal growth. Mm-hmm. Amazing education systems, so great universities, populations who want to stay in their place rather mm-hmm. than necessarily migrate to the south of England. And then because of the location of some of these huge sustainable energy investments, like off the coast of the northeast of England or the west, whole new clusters mm-hmm. of industry. So the opportunities for Thai investors mm-hmm. is not just Grade A London property.
Yes.
Actually, it's tapping into these phenomenal white hot areas of our mm-hmm. economy elsewhere in the country and feeding investment into these new industries such as deep tech, AI, and sustainable energy, which I think will give them phenomenal returns and be great places to invest, even if we didn't support you in terms of the government sitting alongside you.
Yes, right now Thai government has so many projects. So one thing is a virtual bank issue for the virtual bank project. So how the UK government interested to invest for the virtual bank branch in Thailand?
For the virtual bank.
Yes.
Well, in terms of financial services. Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, that's probably a question, more of a question for the specific mm-hmm. banks and organisations. But I mean, when I talk to the big UK banks like yes. HSBC and Standard Chartered, mm-hmm. they're investing very heavily actually in operations in this country. I think they definitely want to expand their capabilities, and I'm very keen to support them. But I think when I look at financial services, I'm really intrigued by, as you say, fintech,
yes.
insurtech, mm-hmm. regtech, blockchain.
Mm-hmm.
These new technologies revolutionize how people can monetize their assets. So if you look at tokenization, well, again, we're leading the world in many of our businesses based in mm-hmm. London, and virtual banking and the ability to transfer money very cheaply, the reduction of friction when it comes to sort of movement of capital. A lot of this is being invented and developed in the UK. And it's very helpful that we have a good relationship and good dialogue with countries mm-hmm. such as Thailand and the regulators here. Mm-hmm. Because by removing friction, you create more liquidity and more activity, which then allows you to allocate capital better.
Yes.
And it puts more money back into the Thai economy and allows us to get richer. So this is all something that I encourage.
For last question, Minister, in the future, how UK and Thailand is enhanced for cooperation on the financial status?
I mean, there's so much we can do.
Yes.
I'm so excited. As I say, I've been privileged enough to spend decades mm-hmm. looking at Thailand for investment opportunities in my previous life. So I feel very fortunate to be able to come here today as a government minister to promote a really close cooperation
yes.
between Thailand and the UK. As I say, many of our best brands mm-hmm. in the UK and sports teams and everything else are owned by Thai companies, and some of the biggest companies in Thailand and some of the largest amounts of capital investment come from UK companies investing in Thailand. Ah. So what I really want to do now is use this conference today and the work of our embassy and team on the ground here to springboard into really powerful dialogues mm-hmm. that result in meaningful reductions of barriers, increased collaboration, more cooperation, and more capital flows between the two countries.
Wow, great cooperation. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much indeed.
No,
a huge pleasure.
To join our interview today.
Thank you so much.
Yes,
real pleasure.
My pleasure.
Thanks a lot.
Yes.